I often would have conversations with my parents in later years about how in the world did we ever end up in Walkersville after all. I know I bugged you to death as a little kid about not wanting to ride the bus anymore and really wanting to go to school in Walkersville. And one time my mom shared with me the story behind how we got here. We actually got here as a part of an initiative by the NAACP's Education Committee and also a committee from Frederick County Public Schools. Frederick County Public Schools wanted to comply with the Brown decision, but they wanted to do it in such a way where there wouldn't be what they thought any of as any possibility of there being any violence. So they wanted to do it in very measured pieces. In 1956, they were forced to integrate the schools in Brunswick because the Brunswick Colored School burned down. So they moved that small population of black students into the Brunswick Elementary School. In 1957, the decision was made through a conversation with Mr. Nickens, who was the president of the NAACP and chaired the education committee for the NAACP, and my father, related to the Smith family in Walkersville being willing to have their children actually integrate the schools here in Walkersville. The family had an excellent reputation. We had been brought up in the community, and it was a feeling by the NAACP and also by the FCPS personnel that it would be a friendly kind of desegregation. So the decision was made by my father that rather than them driving us to Frederick to school, that we would be going to school here in the Walkersville community. My father was a member of the Masons, and he was also the exalted ruler of the Elks in Frederick for a number of years, and my mother was a member of the Elks as well. And it was there, those connections, I'm sure, that also were behind why we ended up going to school in Walkersville. I think that the decision my parents made had to have been a heart-wrenching one for them because they knew that we were going to be running into prejudice and discrimination in our schooling settings. They knew we ran into it in the community at large, so they knew we were going to be running into it now in our education settings. But to their credit, they were always there to try to answer any questions that we had and to be able to be the support we needed to be successful in the schools here in Walkersville.